Welcome students for today's lecture on gantry girder. So in the previous class we have discussed about the gantry girder, a numerical has been taken. So let us go through it. So this was the given data whatever we had, then we calculated the design forces, that is maximum V load. So we computed it and we came across the maximum V load as 483, but on each wheel it is 241.5 kilonewton. Then we placed these wheel loads for the maximum bending moment case. For the maximum bending moment, how we placed it? One of the wheel should be at 1/4 distance of the wheel base. So we computed the 1/4 distance of wheel base, which worked out to be 0.875. So 0.875 at a distance of 0.875, one of the wheel was placed, and from here at 3.5 meter distance, the other wheel was placed. And UDL is nothing but the dead load which has been placed. So dead load was so much, that is 3.45. Then we computed the maximum bending moment, separate for live load and separate for dead load. So for live load we worked out and we got the maximum bending moment as 89.6 kN meter. And bending moment due to impact, we increased it by 10%. So the total bending moment due to dead load and impact load was 648.56 kN meter. Bending moment due to dead load, so dead load is a UDL, you can see here, it's a UDL, hence UDL will be only WL square by 8, so WL square by 8, we computed it, we got it as 27.6 kN meter. Maximum bending moment, we got it as addition of bending moment due to live load and then bending moment due to dead load. So bending moment due to live load was 648.56 and dead load was 27.6. So the total was 676.16 kilonewton meter. So today we will discuss about how to calculate the maximum shear force for this. Now for shear force, again we will keep the live load. So shear force will be maximum at the support. Hence we will keep one of the wheel at the support. So it is at the support 241.5 kilonewton and at a distance of 3.5 meters. So 241.5. So after computing, so you can see here RC into 8, 241.5 into 8, 241.5 into the remaining distance 4.5. So we got RC 377.34, which is the maximum shear force on the wheel load. Now this is 377.34 is due to live load, but there is also a dead load present as a UDL, which is 3.45. Hence the maximum shear force will be nothing but WL by 2. So W is 3.45 into L is 8 divided by 2, which is working out to be some amount, and the total will be shear force due to live load is 377.3 and shear force due to dead load will be added to it, and we got it as 391.15 kN. So this is how the maximum shear force is to be calculated. Now let us see how to calculate the lateral forces. So let us go back. So in the initial stage I have given the conditions like how the lateral force are to be calculated. So you can see here for high end operated OT crane, the lateral loads is equal to 5% of maximum static wheel load, and the longitudinal loads are 5% of weight of crab and weight lifted, and the maximum permissible deflection was L by 500. So let us calculate the lateral loads. So when we come to the calculation of lateral forces, you can see lateral force transferred to the rails. So it is nothing but the longitudinal loads. So it is 5% of the weight of the crab, that is crab or trolley, both are same, and the weight lifted. Hence the weight lifted is 200 and the weight of the crab is 40, so it is 240. And 5% means 5 divided by 100, which is 0.005, which is working out to be 12 kilonewton. So the factored load on the force is 1.5 into 12, which is 18 kilonewton. Then this is the total of lateral force, but on each wheel how much? So there are two wheels, hence lateral force on each wheel will be 18 divided by 2, which is 9 kilonewton. Now let us find out the maximum reactions there. Okay. So here you can see the maximum horizontal reaction due to the force by proportion at C. So let us see what is that C. You can see here we have taken, this is the gantry girder span 8 meters and this is C here, so RC and RD. So we are calculating the lateral force at C and D. So So let us see. So maximum horizontal reaction due to lateral force by proportion at C. So at C is nothing but, so I have converted into a formula. So the formula will be lateral force into reaction at C due to vertical load divided by the maximum wheel load due to vertical load. So lateral force on each wheel we have computed, which is 9 kN. So here I have substitute 9. Then reaction at C due to the vertical load. So reaction we already know. So reaction at C is this one, 377. So 294.33. So this is nothing but here we have computed the reaction. Just we'll go through it. So the reaction is 294.44. Okay. So here it, you can see the due to live load is 294.33 kN. So that is there due to live load, because the lateral force is live load. So 294.33. And a maximum wheel load due to vertical load. This is nothing but the first parameter, that is single wheel load, that is maximum wheel load on each wheel. So 241.5. So after substituting 9 into 294.33 divided to 241.5, we get it as 10.97 kN. Now this is at C. So we have to also find it out at D. But we know the total force is nothing but 18 kN. Hence, we will deduct. So, horizontal reaction due to lateral force at D. So, it will be total load, that is 18, minus the reaction at C. So, 10.97, which is working out to be 7.03 kN. So, this is how we are going to find out the horizontal reaction at C and horizontal reaction at D. Now, why we found out the reaction? Because we wanted maximum bending moment due to the lateral load. So, how to calculate maximum bending moment? I have converted this again into a formula. Everything written in blue you can see here. So, lateral force on each wheel divided by maximum wheel load on each wheel of the crane into maximum bending moment due to live load. So, lateral load on each wheel we have computed here, which is 9 kN. So, it is 9 here divided by maximum wheel load on each wheel is 241.5. And this 589 is nothing but maximum bending moment due to live load. So earlier we have found out. So let us see. So this is the maximum bending moment due to live load here. This is nothing but maximum bending moment due to live load. So this will come here. So it has come here. Maximum bending moment due to live load. Hence we got it as 21.97. Similarly, maximum shear force due to the live load. So the maximum shear force, how to calculate? Again, the formula will remain like this only. So it will be lateral force on each wheel divided by the maximum wheel load on each wheel of the crane multiplied by maximum shear force due to live load. Now it will be maximum shear force. So again, 9 divided by 241.5 will be same, that is this and this. This will be nothing but the maximum shear force. So the let us see what was the maximum shear force. Hence the maximum shear force was 377.34, hence it is 377.34. So we got it as 13.92. Now this is how to find out the lateral forces. So first you have to find out the reaction, the lateral wheel load, then find the distribution, then find out maximum bending moment, and then find out the maximum shear force. So this is how we have to solve for it. So we will see the other part in the next class. Thank you.